الله Almighty says, واسألهم عن القرية التي كانت حاضرة البحر إذ يعدون في السبت إذ تأتيهم حيتانهم يوم سبتهم شرعا ويوم لا يسبتون لا تأتيهم كذلك نبلوهم بما كانوا يفسقون. Very interesting story. A town, Banu Israel, or a group of the Israelites were living in this town, and they have a nice shore. They go fishing and they prosper out of that. Allah the Almighty tested those people of the Israelites because on Sabbath they are not supposed to work. They are not supposed to earn. That's their day off, their holiday. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tested them and tested their patience when it comes to the earning. The fish would come particularly on Saturday in abundance, more than any other day of the week. So it's very tempting. So a group of them thought about it and came up with an evil idea, which is, Allah said, you should not fish on Saturday. We're not gonna fish on Saturday. How? They will cast their nets and collect the fish and keep it in the water. Then they will collect it, take it out of the water next morning. So they said, we didn't take it out of the water. It's like reserved. But the actual fishing took place on Saturday. This is like cutting corners. But the end, whom do you deceive? You think you can ever deceive the Almighty Allah? No, you broke command. So another people gave them da'wah, and they said, this is haram, and God have said you shouldn't do this, and you are violating the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And there is a third group. The third group are the, in my opinion, are the worst. Because they were not only passive, and they didn't say it's none of our business, so we're not going to talk about it. No, they rather went to the active Israelites, the good ones of them who was trying to stop the evil, and they said, why do you bother? Why do you give them nasiha? If Allah is going to destroy them, let Him destroy them. This is none of your business. So those who were active in da'wah, they said, نَذِرَةً إِلَىٰ رَبِّكُمْ وَلَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَّقُونَ. And we teach our students in the methodology of da'wah class that why do we give da'wah? Look for these two reasons. مَعْذِرَةً إِلَىٰ رَبِّكُمْ وَلَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَّقُونَ 164, chapter number 7. مَعْذِرَةً إِلَىٰ رَبِّكُمْ يعني to be excused by Allah. Because Allah said, عليكم أنفسكم لا يضركم من ضل إذا اهتديتم. So as long as you're taking care of yourself and you're enjoining what is good and forbidding what is bad, you're not blameworthy. The blame will be only on those who violate Allah's prohibitions. ولعلهم يتقون. Perhaps they will take heed and our nasiha will benefit them and they will become righteous. They didn't like it. So 165 tells us in a very interesting way the outcome of this. So now, if you're following me, we have three parties living in this town. Those who happen to catch the fish and leave it in the nets and violate Allah's prohibition on Saturday. The second group, those who enjoined what is good and forbid them again is the evil. The third group, they were passive with regards to the oppressors and the wrongdoers, and they came to the good doers, those who were given da'wah, and they tried to stop them. So Allah the Almighty says in number 165, فَلَمَّا نَسُوا مَا ذُكِّرُوا بِهِ أَنْجَيْنَا الَّذِينَ يَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ السُّوءِ وَأَخَذْنَا الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا بِعَذَابٍ بَئِيسٍ بِمَا كَانُوا يَفْسُقُونَ. So when they neglected what they were commanded to do, and the reminders, Allah said, أَنْجَيْنَا, we saved, الَّذِينَ يَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ السُّوءِ, we saved those who used to forbid evil, alone, only. And then the rest, وَأَخَذْنَا الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا بِعَذَابٍ بَئِيسٍ بِمَا كَانُوا يَفْسُقُونَ. And we have seized الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا, the disbelievers بعذاب بئيس with a rich punishment because of what they used to do, because of their rebelliousness. So those who were passive and those who did not do da'wah, those who did not forbid the evil were also perceived as يفسقون.